Nigeria is now the second most corrupt country in West Africa, according to the recently released Corruption Perception Index by Transparency International. The index, which sees Nigeria take 149th position following Guinea-Bissau, which is ranking 165th position. The index also was released in Abuja and puts a dent to the current administration's anti-corruption war. Our correspondent Idong Joseph reports.
The recently released Corruption Perception Index by Transparency International shows a steep decline in Nigeria's anti-graft war in the last 1 year. The 2020 report, published by the Civil Society Legislative Advocacy Center, CISLAC, in collaboration with Transparency International Nigeria, reveals that Nigeria lost 1 point within the last 1 year, scoring 25 points out of 100 points.
The Corruption Perception Index aggregates data from 8 different sources that provide perception by Nigeria's business community and country experts on the level of corruption in public sector. While the index does not show specific instances of corruption, it is an indication of the perception of the Nigerian public about the state of corruption in Nigeria.
CISLAC and other stakeholders fault the poor performance in the anti-corruption war to the lack of transparency in the management of COVID-19 emergency relief funds, nepotism in public appointment, lack of an anti-corruption framework, corruption in the security sector, bribery and extortion by police personnel,
hoarding of relief materials and diversion of these materials, which are then used as personal souvenirs, presented to the political party loyalists and close associates.
The repeated failure to enact the Proceeds of Crime Act as a legal framework for the management and utilization of recovered assets in Nigeria, which is one of the key pillars of this administration's anti-corruption strategy, is inexplicable.
Nigeria's security system is also perceived to be politicized. Leaders are often appointed based on their political allegiances rather than on their experience or capacity in law enforcement.
They urge government to rebuild the confidence of citizens by formulating and implementing relevant legislations that will strengthen the anti-graft agencies.
Government needs to, as a matter of urgency, institute a framework that deals with transparency in the utilization of COVID-19 relief fund by state and non-state actors. This must be ensured as a measure and mechanism to rebuild confidence between citizens and the state.
It is very important to have a legislation in place because it has that legal binding. You know, this is just a policy. A policy doesn't have that kind of legal binding that a legislation has. So if we have the Whistleblower Act, you know, that will go a long way in helping fight against corruption.
While there has been commendable effort by the Nigerian Police Complaint Response Unit, CRU, in reducing police abuses, there is need to scale up the effort of the unit to meet the demand of citizens as contained in the Police Act 2020.
With the current administration riding on the mantra of a war against corruption before coming into office in 2019, the recently released index raises many questions in their need of answers. Idong Joseph, Plus TV Africa.
Hello, hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.